Hey guys, welcome back to class. My name is Tom Huggett. We'll be going through a couple of things after you've just finished doing the watching the PowerPoint. So yeah, obviously the PowerPoint we just went through on aerobic and anaerobic exercise for individual athletes as well as group team sport athletes, right? So obviously using all that knowledge that we've learned from the start of the lesson with aerobic and anaerobic exercise, we're going to go on to another little topic of conversation for today's lesson. And it's a new topic you may or may not have heard of before. It is called the FIT principle, right? It is an acronym, and it is used mainly and predominantly for exercise programming throughout the exercise world, right? So the FIT principle is obviously an acronym and it stands for frequency, intensity, time, and type, right? So I'm going to get all your guys' input in regards to what you believe or what you think this might be, right? I'm not going to do a task really quickly. We're just going to run through this and then we'll do a little activity after, okay? So frequency in regards to exercise programming. What do you guys think the F for frequency stands for, what it means? Yep. So frequency means how often during a week the exercise program is undertaken by the athlete. Okay, so that means, for example, a beginner athlete most likely will be programmed to do the program, or do the exercise program about one, two, or three days a week. If it's 3 days a week, it's most likely going to be not as strenuous on the athlete because they are only just starting out, nonetheless, right? And then for an advanced and an elite athlete, we're going to say that their frequency is going to be higher. It's going to be about 6 days a week, most likely. So usually they go by the week because that's obviously easier to measure in the long run. Okay, frequency is an F. The I is intensity. I'm going to give that to you straight away. And the intensity is how hard pretty much how hard the exercise program is. Okay? So for example, a beginner athlete is given a program and it's a couple of different exercises that aren't as strenuous on the body, aren't as hard. Or they'd be given, you know, a lighter weight or lighter amount, a less amount of reps or something if that's a strength exercise or a strength exercise program. Okay, or less kilometers run if it's an aerobic exercise program, that kind of thing. Also, just one small thing to note in regards to intensity, right? Intensity can also be affected by the amount of break times in between exercises, especially if it's a strength or a hypertrophy styled exercise program in the gym. If there is a shorter amount of rest time in between each exercise, the more aerobically you'll be working between those exercises, right? Which will create a higher intensity within the athlete while doing that program. Okay, it's going to become going to be more calories burned. There's going to be more huffing and puffing, more aerobic energy expenditure throughout that exercise program, okay? So that's intensity. Now, the next T, what do you guys think that the first T of the FIT principle stands for? Now, you've got a couple of things, but you've got two T's. So if you guess the last one, I'll let you know if it's the last one. No. But the first T is time. Right? So time it means in the FIT principle means how long those individual exercises within the program are going for, as well as how long the program is in general. Advanced athletes are going to usually have an hour and a half to 2 hour programs, okay? Because that's how long they will need to fit all their programming into that one time limit, right? It's about, you know, it differs between athletes. And then the beginner athletes obviously are going to have a shorter amount of time. Okay, so that's time. The last T of the FIT principle stands for type. Okay, so type of exercise. Depending on the athlete, different types of exercises are going to be needed for whatever their goals, for whatever, like, to achieve whatever goals they're wanting to achieve. Now, if you go further into the exercise world as an exercise professional or a sports and exercise scientist or an exercise physiologist or a physio, different clients, different people are going to come to you with their certain goals that they want to achieve. Okay? Now, for you to help them achieve this, you're going to have to choose types of exercises and types of programs to help them achieve that. Okay? You've got swimming that you can use as a great mode of exercise to help assist an athlete or a client to get their goals. You've got strength, hypertrophy exercise programs, aerobic exercise programs, anaerobic exercise programs. The list is ongoing, right? And this is what that last team, the Fit Principle, represents, the type of exercise that you prescribe to the client for them to get to their goals. And the type of exercise obviously helps all the other parts of the acronym with the frequency and the intensity and the time limit. The type of exercise is going to affect how long. Obviously, a 3 kilometer run is going to take a lot longer in terms of time, right? And it's going to be a lot more intense than, for example, 1 rep max of a bench press, or 1 rep max of a deadlift, or 1 rep max of a squat. Okay? So the type of exercise affects all those other categories in terms of the Fit Principle. Okay? So that's why it's at the end of the acronym, because that one affects everything else. So make sure that you're obviously picking all those different parts of the Fit Principle when programming an exercise program for an athlete. You have to take everything else into consideration very, very carefully. Okay? Are there any questions on those 4 parts of the Fit Principle? Fantastic. Right. Since there are no questions, this next activity for you guys should be fairly straightforward. Okay? What I need you guys to do is I need you guys to grab a piece of paper and a pen. And I want you guys to write FITT down the page in big letters. Enough space between each time that you write it for a little bit of writing. What you're going to do is you're going to prescribe an exercise program to someone who is a beginner with using the FIT principle. And what you guys are going to do is you're going to go down FITT and you're going to write what you're prescribing them in terms of frequency, intensity, time, and type. And then underneath it, write a little blurb, write a little paragraph about how you're going to assist this athlete or this client in progressing with progressive overload to make that program harder for them to complete, to get muscular and aerobic and strength gains. Okay? Awesome. Thank you so much, guys.